The new iPhone 17 Pro's vapour chamber cooling is so good that the phone keeps cool even while AI is working hard. The Apple iPhone 17 Pro has a vapour chamber that moves heat away from the A19 Pro SoC and spreads it out across the aluminium unibody. A fresh report says that the iPhone 17 Pro's cooling system is really good, since it can keep the phone cool even when it is doing a lot of AI work. The Apple iPhone 17 Pro and 17 Pro Max are two of the most powerful smartphones on the market right now. This is because they have the great A19 Pro SoC. The A19 Pro gives the iPhone 17 Pro and iPhone 17 Pro Max more power and efficiency, as well as vapor chambers to keep the devices cool. Combined with aluminium unibodies that are far better at thermal conductivity than titanium frames, Apple promises that the iPhone 17 Pro and the 17 Pro Max give incredible performance while remaining comfortable to hold. After putting the iPhone 17 Pro through a lot of AI testing, Argmax found exactly what you said. According to Argmax, a company that makes AI tools, the vapor chamber inside the iPhone 17 Pro not only makes the AI work much better, but it also keeps the phone cool, even when it is under a lot of stress. Argmax investigated how well the iPhone 17 Pro, iPhone 16 Pro, and iPhone 17 kept cool by having them transcribe 30 minutes of a YouTube video in real time with sub-second latency. The fact that the test was run on the GPU of the iPhone 17 Pro and the iPhone 16 Pro, and not the neural engine, makes the strain on the smartphone even worse. The iPhone 17 employed the neural engine in this test, which is far more efficient and creates less heat. What happened? The Apple iPhone 17 Pro's vapor chamber and aluminium unibody combined for a capable pairing to dissipate heat, as the smartphone only heated up to 29 degrees Celsius. In contrast, the iPhone 16 Pro, which lacks a vapor chamber and has a titanium frame, hit 40 degrees Celsius. The iPhone 17 also stayed below 30 degrees Celsius. To put it simply, the iPhone 17 Pro and the iPhone 17 Pro Max appear to be exceptional when it comes to controlling thermal load. So, whether you are just using your phone for social media, filming 4K videos, or gaming, the iPhone 17 Pro and the iPhone 17 Pro Max should stay pleasant to hold for long periods of time. In conclusion, Apple has greatly elevated the priority for attaining market-leading performance for big transformer inference workloads with the A19 and A19 Pro CPUs in the iPhone 17 series. Most of these enhancements came out of the box with iOS 26. Despite considerable advancements, getting top performance on the neural engine still feels like black magic to most engineers. On the other hand, the GPU is directly programmable with Metal, and frameworks like NLX make it highly accessible to install popular models with near-peak utilization on Apple Silicon GPUs. This is why the neural accelerators on GPU announcement is a very promising route for extremely accessible high-performance inference on Apple Silicon. We have seen up to a 3.1x speed increase from the iPhone 16 Pro to the iPhone 17 range on the GPU. The stated improvement was up to 4x, and the remaining gains may emerge as the underlying Apple inference frameworks, MPS Graph, the GPU backend for Core ML, improve. MLX developers said that they will start implementing support for these new cores in the next weeks. Nonetheless, the Apple Foundation model, a transformer with 3 billion parameters, is still deployed on the neural engine for several good reasons. Top energy efficiency to maximize battery life, natively accelerated advanced compression techniques, and higher peak throughput, even after the A19 Pro updates to the GPU. Next, the iPhone 17 Pro Max versus the iPhone 16 Pro Max, Apple's got a new top phone. iPhones don't typically get substantial enhancements over their predecessors, but Apple has really shaken things up this year, introducing some of the greatest changes to the lineup in a long time. Sure, there aren't any new buttons this time around, but the iPhone 17 Pro Max has received a cosmetic upgrade from the iPhone 16 Pro Max, and there are even bigger improvements behind the scenes. So, is the iPhone 17 Pro Max worth upgrading to, or should you stick with the iPhone 16 Pro Max? Here, we'll take a deeper look at how these two phones compare to help you make that decision. You'll get a full look at the characteristics and features of these phones as shown, along with their costs. But first, here's just a brief review of their spec sheets, so you can see how they compare at a glance. The iPhone 17 Pro Max was available from September 19, though at the time of writing you might be waiting longer than that, as it's in great demand. The iPhone 16 Pro Max, meanwhile, launched in September of 2024, but Apple has already discontinued it, so you can't buy it straight from Apple. Buying it fresh from retailers is still viable right now, but it could become increasingly tough over the following several months unless you're happy to look at pre-owned or refurbished machines. If you move up the price bands, then the iPhone 16 Pro Max pricing remains comparable to that of the iPhone 17 Pro Max, except in Australia at least, where the new phone is significantly more expensive. Though note that the iPhone 16 Pro Max tops out at 1 TB of storage, so you can't get a 2 TB variant. From the front, though, the two phones look significantly more similar, as they both have a flat screen with a dynamic island at the top. Both phones also contain an action button and a camera control key. Their weights and dimensions do differ, though, with the iPhone 17 Pro Max coming in at 163.4 × 78 × 8.8 mm and 233 grams, while the iPhone 16 Pro Max is 163 × 77.6 × 8.3 mm and 227 grams. So Apple's latest phone is somewhat taller, wider, thicker, and heavier. The colors also differ, with the iPhone 17 Pro Max being marketed in silver, cosmic orange, and deep blue tones, while the iPhone 16 Pro Max is available in black titanium, white titanium, natural titanium, and desert titanium. Some less visible design elements include their water and dust resistance, with both phones having an IP68 rating, and the protection on their screens, with the iPhone 16 Pro Max using ceramic shield, while the iPhone 17 Pro Max uses ceramic shield 2, which is said to offer 3 times better scratch resistance. These are both wonderful looking phones, and it will be subjective which you prefer, with our iPhone 17 Pro Max review characterizing it as having a fresh, possibly divisive look, and our iPhone 16 Pro Max review applauding its iconic design with excellent materials. Still, while the appearances themselves are down to personal opinion, the improvement in scratch resistance alone gives the new phone a minor advantage here. The iPhone 17 Pro Max and iPhone 16 Pro Max both have 6.9-inch 1,320 × 2,868 OLED panels with a 120Hz refresh rate and 460 pixels per inch resolution. Both have a dynamic island, both support always-on display, and both have a 2:1 contrast ratio. So there's really very little to choose between them on this front. However, they're not exactly identical. You see, whereas the iPhone 16 Pro Max's max outdoor brightness is 2000 nits, the iPhone 17 Pro Max increases it to 3000 nits. On top of that, the iPhone 17 Pro Max also sports a new anti-reflective coating on its screen. The consequence is that the newer phone's display should look less washed out in intense sunshine and should pick up fewer reflections. There hasn't been much in the way of screen changes otherwise, but that's great, because they weren't really needed. As our iPhone 17 Pro Max review has it, images pop and blacks are as inky and dark as you would hope they'd be. While Apple doesn't publish the capacity of its phone's batteries, certifications have shown that the iPhone 17 Pro Max has a 5,088 milliamps battery in the US and a 4,832 milliamps one overseas. The difference is because the phone is eSIM only in the US, so there's space for a larger battery. The iPhone 16 Pro Max, meanwhile, has a 4,685 milliamps battery wherever you buy it, so it's a lower capacity, and that translates to worse longevity. Apple claims the iPhone 17 Pro Max will last for up to 37 hours of video playback between charges, while the figure for the iPhone 16 Pro Max is 33 hours. Our own tests similarly revealed that the new model lasts longer, and it charges faster too, with a 40-watt or higher charger able to power it to 50% in roughly 20 minutes, while the iPhone 16 Pro Max will take around 35 minutes to get the same level of charge. But while the iPhone 17 Pro Max is the clear winner for battery life, the iPhone 16 Pro Max still has many phones beat, so neither handset should disappoint on this front. This may not be a major surprise, but the iPhone 17 Pro Max is an advance over the iPhone 16 Pro Max in every area above other than pricing, with everything from its chipset to its RAM, its cameras, its screen brightness, and its battery life all increased over the previous generation. Plus, there's the redesigned vapour chamber, which should enhance performance. The display hasn't been greatly updated, admittedly, and the new design could be contentious, but in most aspects the new model is a superior phone, and Apple hasn't even had to hike the price to do this. Whether it's worth buying if you already have the iPhone 16 Pro Max is more arguable, and you might want to read our complete iPhone 17 Pro Max review before choosing. But of the two, it's certainly the better phone, and if you're rocking a device that's a few years old, then switching to the iPhone 17 Pro Max should make a night and day difference. So, let us know your thought in the comments section. Then we'll see you in the next one. Goodbye, and see you tomorrow.